maintaining the presentation of colors all about any location. Chief Petty Officer, United Stadium, arriving. Captain, United States Navy, arriving. Color guard, brave the colors. Ladies and gentlemen, the National Anthem. Dr. Heath will now deliver the Pledge of Allegiance.
Good morning. It seems it's actually our tradition that atheists be atheists, agnostics, skeptics. We don't bow our heads and close our eyes in reference to the sort of divine. But if that is what your tradition is, we also respect you. You choose to bow your head, because you're actually welcome to do so. But for those of us who are humans, we see strength and potential within ourselves and also each other. So I would ask you at this moment, if it is not your tradition to bow your head and close your eyes, to look to each other, and also to Chief Petty Officer Doug Wright. This morning, we're here to celebrate. Part of the invocation that I have, something that Chief Petty Officer Doug Wright didn't know that I would bring with me today. A letter from Colonel Irwin Camp, Chief of Chaplains of His Majesty's Royal Dutch Marines, who sends greetings. He says to Chief, I wish you a very good retirement and hope that your experience can be used to volunteer good. Here in the Netherlands, we work with a lot of Dutch veterans, and I know that there's a lot of work to do. Perhaps one day we can meet and congratulate each other more of an acceptance of humanists and other non-theistic people in the United States Armed Forces. All the best, your Facebook friend, Colonel Irwin Camp, Chief of Chaplains. For the invitation, we're here to celebrate. We're here to celebrate service. If you look around the room, you can see stripes, battle stars, ribbons, ranks, people that have given service to this country. We celebrate that. We celebrate teamwork and getting a job done. We celebrate the fact that all of us are different, that we need each other to be able to achieve greater goals. We're here to celebrate friendships, knowing that tonight we might say, "Yo, Navy, beat Army." And tonight, even tomorrow morning, we're still friends. We celebrate that friendship. We celebrate families of the Navy and other branches of the military. And we celebrate the families beyond the military, because we know the sacrifices that they have made to allow each of us to be here today for this momentous occasion. And above all, we celebrate the relationships that we have with people that are different. There can be unity without having to be uniform. And for that, we are very grateful.
Thank you. Good morning. I would like to welcome you all to this special occasion. The Navy retirement ceremony is steeped in traditions dating back to the 1700s. It is meant to celebrate the conclusion of a successful military career, the best parallel to shipmates as they depart from active service and rejoin the civilian community. It is the nation's expression of appreciation for a job well done, a sincere official recognition of a long period of faithful and honorable service. It is a day of great significance, making the commander of the British Navy rewarding way of life, being part of naval operations, contributing to the welfare of the nation and the events of freedom everywhere. Today we gather to bid a formal farewell to Chief Wright, who has given 24 years of his life in service to his country. We are also gathering to say thanks for a good shipment. Thanks for his good contributions, which in their unique way have made our Navy be stronger and more capable for us in our ever-ending fight for peace and sometimes troubled world. Thanks to the committed dedicated hours and personal initiative that helped to make the Navy the proud professional organization it is today. Just as this is the end of one day of his life, it's the beginning of another. So our gathering today offers to give us the opportunity to wish him every success in the future and look forward to new challenges and rewards. I extend a special warm welcome to Chief Wright's life, Heroes, and his children, and Naomi, Chris, Ian, and my husband. I know that you know more than any of us are readily aware of the sacrifice that Chief Wright has made in the service of our country. And I speak to the entire command when I say how pleased we are to have you here today. We would like to give a special welcome to the morning Chief Wright family, though they do not wear the uniform but also serve. His mother and brother, Nadine and Nicholas, are joining us today from the bottom to share this very special day. During today's ceremony, the Chief Mayor of the Wright will be presenting the awards and medals recognizing and expressing the nation's grateful appreciation for his service. This ceremony will conclude when, for the last time, the retiring service member is hired over the side. This is a distinct day of courtesy, uses distinguished persons, and bid final farewell to our children. Now I would like to introduce Captain Lopez. More importantly, though, Captain Lopez calls for a moment. He is graduated from the Naval Academy in 1995 and has since served in joint Navy positions in Atlantic, Pacific, and the Middle East. Currently serves as the coordinator manager for the support program at the Royal Navy Regiment. He graduated as a computer science and a master's in information technology management. Captain Lopez is married to Sarah Lopez and serves as a judge advocate in the U.S. Navy.
Well, I knew that Seaman had really meant to say, kind of chief, rightfully so, stopped the young man, made sure he understood the necessities of the saluting. And then we proceeded down the path. I said, chief, what's the big deal? It's the first lesson that I was ever taught by chief, the first of many, many lessons that chief taught me was the necessity and the importance of the formalities and how it applies us. It's my great pleasure to be here this morning and be part of Chief Petty Officer's retirement ceremony. Ceremonies and formalities are important. They make important moments in time, and they ground us in a common heritage. At the start of our careers, early adults, excited and nervous, it's difficult for most sailors to envision the length and breadth of the experiences that the U.S. Navy will provide them. It's difficult to realize that being a sailor can be more than just another job. For those who stay to retirement, the Navy life becomes a way of life. Our race and ratings, our shipmates and commands, our families, all become bound together. So at the end, when at last you decide to put away the uniform one last time, these ceremonies are important. Because while it may be easy for some to just walk away, maybe we shouldn't. Maybe we should take that moment to acknowledge a life of service and what it has meant to us and to those around us. I've had the pleasure of working with Chief for only about 6 months, despite the many challenges and distractions that naturally come at the end of a long career. Chief Wright continued to show those around him his understanding of his role as a Navy chief, quietly committed and leading by example whenever possible, courageously forward when necessary, and always honorable. Chief Wright loved problem solving, whether helping us keep our temperamental video teleconferencing equipment running or helping the fleet out with a variety of issues. He worked hard to track and close those casualties. He worked hard to make sure that the sailors out in the fleet had the very best service that they could get. But it wasn't just about the job. His love of family was also very evident. He kept a lot of pictures of his family in his office space. And more important to me, he always spoke positively about his wife and kids. And I know that he'd been looking forward to being able to spend more quality time with his family after getting his active service. Now, what? What comes the day after? Some may put away the uniform for good and never think about it for the rest of their days. Others, though, and I suspect Chief Wright is among them, remember. They remember the pride of accomplishment, the burden of service, the importance of leadership. Chief Wright, I congratulate you on reaching this important milestone, and from the bottom of my heart, I thank you for your service. I wish you and your family fair winds and following the seas, and I look forward to the great things you will accomplish once you leave the service. Thank you.
Will the guests please rise as Captain Lopez presents the Navy and Marine Corps Commendation Medal to Chief Wright.
Hey, I got that one.
Military attendees, attention to award. Navy Commendation Medal, Gold Star, awarded with the second award. Chief Electronics Technician, Surface Warfare, Douglas Wright, United States Navy. Their service while serving as Assistant Surface Warfare Platform, Guided Missile Destroyer, Platform Patrol Craft, Fleet Readiness Officer, Fleet Readiness Director, Space and Naval Warfare Assistance Command.
Good job, Chief.
San Diego, California, from February 2014 to October 2016. Chief Petty Officer Wright skillfully created a casualty tracking tool that includes the care efforts of 3,000 command, control, communications, computer, intelligent casualties, and reduced mission, affecting casualties by 90%. Chief Petty Officer Wright, devoted to service, was highlighted with volunteers from the Navy and Marine Corps, Police Society Drive, raising $10,000. his unwavering dedication to the 24 years of monumental service. By his noteworthy accomplishments, preservation, devotion, duty, Chief Petty Officer Wright reflected upon himself and upheld the highest tradition of the United States Civil Service. Signed, T.H. Lewis, Rear Admiral, U.S. Navy, Commander of Space and
Chief.
Thank you.
That's a hell of a sea chest. Wow. Nice. Dress whites mounted in there, and the Navy crest.
Here today. One of those things were the things that I learned in my 24 years in the Navy, the things that I'm thankful for in my 24 years in the Navy, and a couple of things that I picked up along the way. Start with the thanks. First and foremost, my wife, Yuko. We met 14 years ago in Japan. Hit it off right away, got married, and haven't looked back once since. And I can say that she has been absolutely my rock and my guide through the years I've been here. Nothing that I've been able to accomplish since I met her would have been as great or as worthwhile if I wasn't able to share it with her. She persevered through a lot of hard times, transitions from Japan to here, a lot of things to get used to, and she did it remarkably well. Deployments, you name it, she did it. So you go, I'm going to say thank you right now. Thank you for everything you did for my mother. I have to say that to my mother, you've always been the model that I've had in my life after. The kind of person that I want to be. It's because of you that I turned out the way that I am, the way that I'm worse. I like to think it was for better. You were always without words and with very, very little push, always were able to guide me in the direction that I needed to go. And for giving me that internal compass, I appreciate it. I thank you. CTOMS, thank you. I've had the pleasure and the honor of being the Chief Petty Officer for 10 years. And I can tell you here right now that being a chief will change you in some way or another. It changes significantly. When I first got into the Navy, I can say that I didn't really have the direction I wanted to go in. I didn't really have a thing I wanted to do. I didn't have ethos. I didn't have a push. The Navy itself really molded me into the person that you see before you today, but it was the Chief Petty Officer Miss at home that related. It showed me how important it was to lead by example, how important it was to live what you preach, and how important it is to stand by what you say. And for that, I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Navy Chief,
let me ride!
And for those that couldn't be here, that helped mentor me through my time in the Navy, the chiefs that I've had, the junior sailors and senior sailors that I've had the honor and the pleasure to lead, you've all taught me something. And I take that with me into my next phase of my life. It's something I'll never forget. For the U.S., I say thank you. So, things that I have learned. I learned that since being in this command, you forget a pair of black socks. Shoe polish will do in the pinch. I had to put that one out there because I know somebody was thinking that. Dave. I learned that we go to sports. The attention to make fair, the fear of sex is not the. It's not because you're a superstar, because you're an American. It's just something that is. I learned first and foremost that leadership does come from within. And it's something that can be taught, but is better to be exposed from inside. And the thing that I most most proud of serving this nation, of these United States. And what I have to say is, not that the thing that we do, because people come up to me and say, thank you for your service, they'll shake your hand, they'll see you in uniform, we're always going to appreciate your death. But it's not the thing that really brought me the problem. The fact that these folks, they see I'm representative of the armed service and they feel compelled to express gratitude. It's not what we do, it's how we do it. Because in the Navy and in the military, historically, we have shown society at large what equality is. We've shown them that it's not how a person was born or what they were, or the ethos that they grew up with, or how they lived. It was what they did. And what you do in the Navy, that alone defines how far you went. And I am incredibly proud of that legacy. I'm incredibly proud to have served in the Woodbridge Navy. I'm incredibly proud to have served at State War. I'm incredibly proud to have known the GFO.
Thank you. Thank you, Chief. Dr. Wendell, I always remember about the real things of symbols of both the flag. Flag and tail, both.
Flag and tail, attention. Flag and tail, side step.
What you are about to witness is a moment of our national flag, some of the symbols of which each flag represents, extracted by each flag for the purpose of giving more personal.
The first hold of our flag is a symbol of life. The second hold is a symbol of our belief in the promise made by our forefathers to stand for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. The third hold is made in honor and remembrance of the veteran departing our ranks and who have gave his or her life for the defense of our country to obtain peace throughout the world. The fourth oath represents our weaker nature. As human beings trusting each other, it is to each other returned in time of peace, as well as in time of war, to comfort and guidance. The fifth oath is traded to our country. For in the words of Stephen Decatur, our country, in dealing with other countries, may she always be right, but it is still our country, right or wrong. The sixth fold is where our hearts lie. It is with our heart that we pledge allegiance to the Republic of the United States of America, one nation, indivisible, have been since he or she was first born. The 11-fold in the eye of the Muslim represents the responsibility for our lives and the kind of world in which we live is ours and ours alone. The 12-fold in the eyes of humanists represents the embracing of a vision with informed conviction that humanity has the ability to progress towards its highest ideals. When the flag is completely folded, the stars are uppermost, reminding us of our first national motto, E pluribus unum, or many one.
Way to go.
Thank you, Dr. Hinton. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Today, we have most of the humble intention of honors, traditions, ceremony, and back to history. Time does not give us the freedom to do all these things in the past, but we still stop all engines, lay about smartly, and draw anchor to pay homage to our shipmates when we shore. To honor the years served, the guidance, the leadership, the friendship, and the expertise that the shipmate has freely given in 24 years. Ladies and gentlemen, see if anybody else is with us, and I'll read the floor.
For 24 years, this sailor has stood the watch. While some of us were in our racks at night, this sailor stood the watch. While some of us were learning our trade in school, this shipmate stood the watch. Yes, even before some of us were born into this world, this shipmate stood the watch. In those years where the storm clouds of war were seen brewing on the horizon, the history, this shipmate stood the watch. Many times we would cast an eye ashore and see his family standing there, needing guidance and help, needing a hand to hold during those hard times. But this shipmate stood the watch. He stood the watch for 20 years. He stood the watch so that we, our families, and our fellow countrymen could see how many, each and every night, knowing that a sailor stood the watch. Today, we're here to say, shipmate, the watch stands for me. We lead by those who have led, guided, and trained. Chief Wright.
Boatswain, sideboard, stand by, pipe to side, shipmate, go to shore. Sideboard, boatswain. All chiefs, past and present, man the rail, shipmate, going ashore. This order has passed on naval ships from 15 times per day, Spanish, French, English, Dutch. Most navies in the world, most powers, and to call for or send ashore ships company officers, visiting officers, dignitaries. Today's modern Navy retirement ceremonies conclude with the retiring being piped ashore. Honors are rendered to the retiring by the five boys who salute their frozen pipes. It is Navy tradition the retiring request permission to go ashore one last time, symbolizing the end of a Navy career. Chief Wright will now request permission to go ashore for the last time. Chief Petty Officer, Surface Warfare, Douglas Wright, United Pirate, departing. Chief Petty Officer Douglas Wright, United States Navy, retired and family departing. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our ceremony. On behalf of Chief Wright and family, thank you for attending this time-honored tradition. Though later we take the observed in the kitchen area.